What is up, everybody? It's Tom, TD3. Welcome back to another video. I was on Reddit last night and just going through answering questions, learning about some other things myself, as I tend to do. And I came across a question that in the EDM production thread where somebody was asking about how to program snare rolls using MIDI drums. So I thought, why not make a video about it? So I'm going to show you guys how to make a snare roll by just programming it using MIDI in Logic Pro. All right, so we're in Logic, and I've got a software instrument pulled up. I'm gonna hit Y to pull up the menu here. I've got a drum kit. I like the snare on Brooklyn. It's a nice kind of like soft impact snare, if you will, rather than a rim shot impact snare. So it's got a nice little body to it that makes it really good for snare builds. So we've got tempo here of 90. So there are two ways you can do this. The first way and the easiest way for me, because I'm a drummer, is to just play it in. So let's hit record. So like if that's the pattern you want, that's one way to do it. And as you can see, the velocities are all kind of correct, more or less. So, but I'll go in here and clean it up just for argument's sake. I've set to 32nd note quantize. And the reason I am is because I want to make sure that my snare rolls in here, that the buzz doesn't get gridded to a 16th note. So I hit 32nd note and then I can go through and double check everything after that. So I'm going to drag that note there. If this is the pattern I want, I'm going to hit A for automation, and then I'm going to adjust the note velocity. So I want the accent every third note until we kind of turn around. So let's just go to kind of around 90 for our ghost notes, if you will, within the snare roll. It's really important, if you want it to sound natural, that you make sure you add accents and ghost notes within the roll. Otherwise, it's going to sound really robotic, and it's not going to sound like an actual drummer would play it. And for me, that's kind of the whole goal, is if you can make it sound like, can a drummer play this? Is a drummer playing this? Could conceivably they have recorded live drums? That's the way that you can not fool your listener, but persuade your listener to believe that what they're hearing is real. And that's kind of the game, right? And this is easy because I've played it in, so I can see where my accents are and where I want them to stay. One thing you'll notice is the first note of each of the rolls is accented, and that's really important too. So you get that brrr, that piques the ear to make you hear that there's a roll happening, that first note. So let's listen. Boom, snare roll. You played in the part, you accent your parts, and a lot of builds have that bunt, bunt, bunt. This pattern fits perfectly with that. All right, so that's one way. We're going to close the piano roll. We're going to delete that. And then here's way number two. What if your tempo is too fast? What if we're at 90 there? What if you're at 120? Let's go to 120 where the tempo is a little bit faster and you kind of would have a harder time playing in what you want, right? This time we're just going to play 16th notes on the way in, and then we're going to build our roll by dragging and dropping. So check this out. Real dirty input there, and I'm gonna have to fill in some notes, get rid of automation. So again, I'm gonna select all. So last time we quantized to 32nd notes. This time I'm gonna go 16th notes to make sure it hits the grid correctly. And then I'm gonna drag and drop, fill in here some of these places. All right, so let's listen to what we've got now. We've got our 16th note pattern, and we'll go through and adjust the velocities in a second, but here's what I want to show you. So let's figure out where we want to add our rolls. So we want to add a roll right here, right? So we're going to select, option, drag, and drop over one 32nd note-ish. Hit quantize to 32nd note there, and snare roll. So then all you would do, again, like we did last time, is you want to come through and adjust your velocities. Again, we'll go kind of around 100 this time of ghost notes. Anywhere, like you can go kind of as low as you want to. Within reason with ghost notes, it's just going to make your accents pop even more. Just remember that adding the ghost note is the key to making it compelling and to sound like a real snare part. And again, accent on the first note of that roll. So we'll get rid of our automation here. Hit A, back to the top. Let's just get rid of this just so you can hear one time through. Boom, marching snare drum for your build. And you can do all kinds of patterns with this. Think about what your lead is doing or your vocal is doing and your synth, whatever it is that's driving the melodic and rhythmic value of that moment in the song. And you can get your snare accents to match that, but just make sure you pull your ghost notes down in between so that that snare is doing its job to support that part. And then the rolls kind of add that flare and transition points and things like that. But yeah, it's really easy. Now you know how to do it. This applies to any other software where you want to be building MIDI snare rolls. I just happen to use Logic for it, but you can do it anywhere. That's it for this one. Thanks for watching, and I hope this helps. I'll catch you guys next time. Peace.